What's happening? It's Darian the Mouth of the South. Great, and it's hoodie season. You see, I got my hoodie on right now, and I'm excited because the temperature's dropped a little bit. A couple degrees down, I can wear my hoodie outside in Texas now. It ain't blistering heat of the summer, but that's not what we're here for right now. We're here to talk about another thing that I'm excited for, and that's football. And on Point Blank Period today, I'm going to tell you why Tampa Bay's victory over the Green Bay Packers could be a season-defining win for them.
You can sleep when you die. Point Blank Period.
And you know this, man.
To start off the game, it looked like Green Bay was going to be on the roll they had been on all year. Two double-digit play possessions, both resulting in points. Then Tampa Bay didn't score any points on their first two possessions. I'm texting and laughing with my boy Tramiel, who has a Packers podcast called Cheesehead Talk that you have to check out. And his Instagram is pick_6, which is ironic because after Jamel Dean intercepted Aaron Rodgers and took it all the way to the house singing Just Hold On, We Going Home, nothing was the same. So I look at it like this. After that play was changed, the whole landscape of the game because Green Bay scored no more points. Green Bay had 9 possessions the rest of the game. The first one after that interception was another interception 3 plays later. Then 7 of the last 8 possessions, Green Bay punted the ball. And the only one of that 8 that did not result in a punt ended in halftime. Like I said, no points. The Green Bay punter, to put in perspective, the Green Bay punter had only punted 7 times all season. He doubled his punt total against the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. That's incredible. They were stout against the pass versus the run. Aaron Jones only had 15 yards on 10 carries, 545 balled out like they always do. Playing in the backfield, both got sacks and tackles for losses. It was truly impressive. That front 7 shut down Green Bay. Now let's take it to the offensive side of the ball. 31 unanswered points to end the game offensively. Green Bay could not touch Tom Brady because the offensive line was protecting him so well. There was no yelling this time. There was no yelling, and I said it. I knew that Tom Brady was going to come back with a vengeance. And no, he didn't have a crazy stat line. He didn't throw for 300, 400 some odd yards. But what he did do was make the throws when necessary. And hello, Gronk. Nice to see you. Because he surely showed up in the pass game this week, having his first touchdown since 2018. It was impressive, not because it was a bunch of yards, but because it was timely. And Leonard Fournette got hurt at the wrong time. He had a 100-yard game against Carolina and then started having ankle issues. And Ronald Jones said, I'm sorry, man, you missed your shot. I truly think that Fournette was going to start getting more carries and was going to start being a feature back. But now Ronald Jones has had 3 back-to-back-to-back 100-yard games. You can't take him out now. You can't limit his carries now. Man, Ronald Jones been playing, and if y'all don't know, Tampa Bay has had a 100-yard rusher in 4 of the last 5 games. So you're telling me that they can play amazing defense. They cannot turn the ball over. They cannot have 1 penalty. Not a single penalty was accepted on the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. I think they had 1 that was committed, but it was offsetting. So great defense. They're not shooting themselves in the foot. They have timely offense, and they can really run the ball. In this game, Tampa Bay proved to the rest of the league that not only can they play with, they can beat a top-tier team in the NFL. And that's why this victory over the Green Bay Packers was a statement win for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Point blank, period.